Good afternoon. After two amazing days, we've come to our culminating event. I believe we have the largest crowd ever in attendance for the Hall of Fame. I think due to this being on our first annual athletics reunion weekend. I'm pleased to welcome the class of 2015 inductees, John, Tracy, Randy, Jim, and Mark. We're gonna hear a lot about you in a little bit, but also the current members of the Hall of Fame. Teal Tomcat selected for the PAC 60th anniversary, and we have our commissioner, Joanne Derrico. Joe, stand up. Commissioner of the President's Athletic Conference. And many alumni and friends of the institution and of the inductees. I also want to recognize somebody else. Our former state representative, who this is the first time I'm able to introduce her as our state senator, Michelle Brooks. And you're going to hear a little bit about him later. He'll be referred to as an assistant wrestling coach, but I've heard Bob Olson had a few other jobs here at Teal College. One of them was the 18th president of Teal College, Bob Olson. For those of you that had an opportunity to do a campus tour, you've already seen this, but if you haven't, please go over and look at the new Hall of Fame room. It's just simply amazing. It's a nice addition to the Bagley Gymnasium. This campus improvement was done in part through the generosity of Senator Roy Wilt Sr., who had the foresight to gather some wood off of the campus property, and it was cut down many years ago. He stored it for decades, and then he donated it back to the college. And that touch there really is a nice symbol of what this is all about, generations and decades of contributions. And so when you see the new Hall of Fame room, know that that wood came from the campus, you know, through those hands. And Roy, thank you for... What a wonderful night to be a Tomcat. What a great time to be at Teal College. This dinner is a celebration of the proud tradition of Tomcat athletics, a tradition that I can guarantee you we're going to grow and build. Right, Jacob Lowry, who I got to sit with, and maybe we'll be here someday. It's also an acknowledgement of all the individuals who truly did follow the Tomcat motto, RYFP, Reach Your Full Potential. I think it's also important to say thanks to the donors that continue to support the program, and thanks for each and every one of you for all you do for Teal College. I encourage you to remain connected to the institution. We have events going on all the time. I think October 10th is a special day you ought to put in your calendars. That's our next homecoming celebration. We have a sesquicentennial year starting up very, very soon, and so we're just going to have a lot of events, and we're going to just keep it going even at a faster momentum, something that's very important in the athletic arena. It's now my pleasure to introduce class of 1974, a member of the President's Cabinet, married to Patty Liepheimer, his junior high sweetheart, Jack Liepheimer.
Thank you, Troy. At this time, we're going to present two special awards to alumni. The first one is called the Meritorious Service and Commitment Award. This award is presented on an annual basis to someone who is usually behind the scenes, someone who contributions may go a little bit unnoticed to the public. This year's recipient is not only an alumnus, but he's also a former employee, Don Achenbaugh. Don. Don served as our Vice President for Facilities from 2003 through 2007. And it was because of Don's efforts behind the scenes that in the fall of 2005, when we won a few football games, we were able to host two NCAA Division III playoff games. That wouldn't have happened without him. As Don mentioned it earlier in his remarks, he is the color commentator for our home football game, or all of our football games. He's been doing that for almost a decade. And I was going to talk about how early he gets here, but since he brought it up, I won't bother to go that way. But I will tell you this. When I approached Don several years ago to be the MC for this event, I said, you know, the thing that you'll get out of it is a free meal. I'm not going to pay you. He said, Coach, whatever you need. And that's been his attitude ever since I've been around him. Don and I had the good fortune to be teammates at one point. He was a young guy as I was on my way out. But it gives me great pleasure to present to you the Meritorious Service and Commitment Award winner. And the inscription on the plaque says, the Meritorious Service and Commitment Award is presented to an individual or organization whose generosity and enthusiastic support have provided enrichment to all Teal Athletics. It's my privilege and pleasure to bring to the podium Mr. Don Achenbach, Class 77.
Well, I've used most of my jokes. You'll have to wait till next year for the rest. But everyone knows how much I love this place. I mean, there is just no place I'd rather be than Teal College. One of the things, the reason I do the things I do for the Division III athletes is I try, even when I was vice president of facilities, we built the baseball field, the softball field. You try to make it as big time as you can make it for a small group, because these folks work just as hard as the big time people. And I think they're under a whole lot more stress. They've got to worry about, how am I going to get this workout in and still make my lab and get something out of it? They have to worry about, I got a poli-sci paper due Friday, but we have a game at Thomas More, which means I'm going to have to turn it in Thursday, but we have a makeup game at Westminster. When am I going to get my paper done? Things that the Division I athletes don't have to worry about. And then they always have the biggest one. How am I going to pay for this next year? Did my parents get the financing arranged so that I could come back? So whatever I can do to help D3 football players, basketball players, athletes, softball, anything you can do, that's what I try to do. That's what we bring to the broadcast on Saturdays. That's what I try to do in everything and when I'm here. So thank you very much for this. I'm on you. Like I said, we'll talk later. Thanks.
Don didn't know that he was receiving this award until he showed up tonight to review the program and get prepared for the tonight's comments. So he was a little bit surprised. This next award is known as our Athletic Alumni Commendation Award. And the Hall of Fame Committee came up with this idea about 5 years ago to recognize athletic alumni who have gone on after they left Teal and have made their life work in the arena of athletics. And tonight it's my pleasure we recognize a gentleman by the name of Tom Wagner. Tom has been involved in high school athletics for 36 years in the Carnes City School District. Since 1993, Tom has been the athletic director of Carnes City. And during that time, he's had a significant impact on countless students, coaches, administrators, and staff. You can read some of Tom's accolades in this evening's program, so I won't go into it now. But I will tell you this, it's safe to say that Tom embodies all the qualifications of the Athletic Alumni Commendation that the Hall of Fame Committee sought to recognize when this award was established. The inscription says on this plaque, the Athletic Alumni Commendation is presented to a former Teal College student-athlete who has been an outstanding role model and has made a significant contribution to his or her community through the field of athletics. It's my pleasure to bring to the podium and present to you this year's Athletic Alumni Commendation recipient, Tom Wagner.
When Jack called me and gave me the words, I must have had an expression, something like, because Jack said, Tom, are you still there? When he was talking to me on the phone. I'm going to try not to be emotional, but I'm very humbled by this award, and I accept it with great pride. At this time, I would like to congratulate all the honorees in going into the Hall of Fame. That is quite an accomplishment, all right, for you and for your families. No one ever gets anywhere by themselves. I have a strong family tie based on the people that I brought this evening. All right. I am so appreciative of my family, my in-laws. My sister and brother traveled a ridiculous amount this evening to come, and I am so thankful that they're here. So Mike and Judy, thank you very much. All right. To my dad, who growing up in the 70s, when I was growing up in the 70s, his goal was that his children were going to get a college education. All right. Those of you that remember the 70s know that that was no easy feat. All right. Being the oldest of the Wagner family, I'm not sure that this was going to be the easiest task, sending me first, all right, to attain this goal. All right. Dad, I love you, and I thank you very much for everything that you've done, and I'm sure Mom would be very proud of all of us at this point. My second family is truly Teal. I graduated from here 36 years ago. I still stay in contact with a group of fraternity brothers and friends of Teal that are sitting back there this evening tonight, and I want to thank all of you for taking time to come here. And yes, Ron, it did happen. Okay, this isn't a roast. Okay. Okay. My Teal family grows deep because I'm not sure that I would have made it without people at Teal to guide me. Now, during the course of this evening, you're going to hear many people talk about a lot of different people, but the names sometimes are the same. Dr. Robert Olson, John Hauser, and Dave Miller, you are Teal. All right. Dr. Olson took care of me, all right, more than a few times. And I am as a matter of fact, he said that he had to get out of it because we were wearing him out, all right. Dr. Olson, thank you for everything. You were a professor, but you were more than a professor, okay? And when I got out, I found that you to be a true friend, and I enjoyed our time together, and thank you very much. John Hauser is a story in himself. All right. And what I mean by that is when I came here, he was the admissions counselor. He was the person that came to my school, convinced me to come here. All right. And I remember when my first son came here, he goes, "Dad, this guy thinks I'm coming here." All right. I said, "You would be the first to say no to John Hauser. John, thank you for everything." Okay. My family, as I said before, and I kind of want to finish with this. All right. Most of you that know me know that my wife, all right, it means everything to me. To say that she's my soulmate would be a mild understatement. If you ask our friends and everything else, all right, there's a reason that she's up for sainthood. Okay. Cindy, you've done everything for me. All right. When I needed a push out the door to do the job that I had to do, you pushed me. When I needed a pat on the back, you didn't always do it. All right, but you were always, I will say this, when I look behind me, you always stood there for me, and I'm very appreciative. I love you very much. In closing, Dr. Van Aken, Leap, you got it going. When I came here in 1975, we didn't have a football field. Okay? We didn't have a track. Okay? We didn't have a baseball field. All right? You got it going. This weekend is indicative of the leadership that you have shown to this college. And I, for one, want to thank you very much from the bottom of my heart. As far as this award is concerned, all right, I'd like to share it. All right, with Carn City. Carn City was a good fit for me, all right? And it was because of Teal that I got that job and I kept that job. I never wanted, it was much like Teal. It was a place that I didn't want to leave. Thank you.
And once again, I'm glad I got my award first. Been tough to follow that. At this time we want to recognize some people. The Teal Tomcats are the members of the President's Athletic Conference, and as part of their 60th anniversary this year, all-time teams were named in all sports. Teal has their fair share of the members on those teams in attendance. Please welcome representing the Tomcats on the 60th PAC anniversary teams. Kelly Barzak, volleyball and basketball. Randy Chicklin, baseball. Mike Donato, football. John Drinocki, swimming in Teal College Hall of Fame. Eric Garrett, baseball in Teal College Hall of Fame. Tracy Henderson Orner, softball. You guys are okay to stand if you'd like. And even if you don't like, stand anyway. Sol Gel Fracky, wrestling in Teal College Hall of Fame. Lynn Jones, baseball, Hall of Fame Selection Committee in Teal College Hall of Fame. Ron Lucian, football, Teal College Hall of Fame. Mike Lewis, wrestling in Teal College Hall of Fame. Clyde Morgan, track, football in Teal College Hall of Fame. Paul Satternow, wrestling, Teal College Hall of Fame. Coach Amy Schaefer, softball, albeit at Bethany, but she's ours now. Dana Spires, wrestling, Teal College Hall of Fame. Dave Thomas, basketball, Teal College Hall of Fame. John Tomlinson, football. Sorry about all those things I said, John. John Tomlinson, football and wrestling, Teal College Hall of Fame. Don Valesky, wrestling, Teal College Hall of Fame. Rod Wilt, wrestling and Teal College Hall of Fame. Ladies and gentlemen, the 60th anniversary, all PAC teams. And please welcome once again the Commissioner of the PAC, Joe Ondurko. Other members of the Hall of Fame in attendance: Linda Cooper, basketball coach; Logan Cribbs, football; Felix Crutrazilla, 1950 football team; Ed Irwin, 1950 football team; Tom Guskey, track; Morris Hill, football and track; Brian Hills, wrestling; Dick Mamajack, football; Coach Bud Maines; Jim Mundock, basketball; Frank Noonan, football and track; Barry Oman, football; Linda Oman, basketball and Hall of Fame selection committee; Marvin Prentice, track; Chris Schenkman, tennis; Frank Strata, football; Todd Venus, football and wrestling; Howard Wires, football; Roy Wolt Jr., wrestling. Ladies and gentlemen, the Teal College Hall of Fame. We're always pleased when we have an event like this when current coaches turn out to support our Hall of Fame. Please welcome the following coaches in attendance: Coach Tim Loomis, basketball; Coach Matt Lowry, wrestling; Coach Dan McMillan, golf; Coach Katie Robbins, lacrosse; Coach Joe Shalley, baseball; Coach Ryan Thornton, basketball and tennis; Coach Craig Thurber, wrestling; and let's not forget the straw that stirs the athletic drink, Athletic Director Jack Liepheimer. Without a sound foundation, our athletic programs would wither on a vine. Our foundation comes from an exceptional academic base. Please welcome Lynn Franken, Vice President, Academic Affairs, and Dean of the College. John Hauser, College Archivist. Terry Law, Vice President of Advancement. Roberta Leonard, Executive Director of the Capital Campaign. Bill Matthews, Alumni Board. Professor David Miller, Hall of Fame Selection Committee. Linda Nocta, Administrative Assistant to the President. Coach Bob Olson, former President, Hall of Fame Selection Committee. Bob Schmall, Vice President for Finance and Management. Craig Smith, Director of Alumni Relations and Assistant Wrestling Coach. I want to just say a moment, if we can just thank Craig again. He did a lot of work getting this thing together. I don't think that I had a day go by that I didn't get an email from the alumni office. So, and I guess tomorrow is his birthday or something. So, and then Ed Topolesky, Sports Information Director, who also works overtime on these things. So, Ed, thank you. And of course, the number one Tomcat fan, President Troy Van Aken, and his outstanding wife, Annette. That's a ton of dignitaries. I want to thank you all for coming and supporting. I mentioned earlier about how hard it is to be a D3 athlete, and it certainly makes it a lot better when they realize that history didn't have to start with them. So thank you very much. And at this time, I think we'd like to bring the president back up to do a very special announcement.
I'm glad to come back up this time. Normally during this event, I get to speak once at the beginning and once at the end, but anybody who wants to do what these two individuals have done will be glad to have me speak three times at every Hall of Fame. We have a proud history here at Teal College in our Tomcat athletics. We have 22 athletic teams, 23 if we count our cheer and dance, even though the NCAA doesn't count them. We have more than 300 current scholar athletes. But tonight I want to talk specifically about our wrestling program and the investment two engaged individuals have made and generously made to the program. The wrestling program here, one of the first things Annette and I noticed is that it just has an amazing tradition here. I think it helped that Gabriella was in Coach Thurber's wife's class, and that's where we got a good education on the importance of wrestling in Greenville and in this region, but specifically here at Teal College. We have 11 of the 12 wrestlers in the Hall of Fame here this evening with us. One of those athletes is Rod Wilt from the class of 1985. He's a two-time All-America in Division III. He finished second in the Nationals at 1985 and third in 1986. He was a National Wrestling Coaches Association Scholar All-American in 1986 and was inducted into the Teal College Hall of Fame in 1996. I think that's the quickest he could have been inducted after 10 years after he had left. Now, he was lucky enough to meet his wife, Jill Gardner Wilt, while a student at Teal College. And on the patio at the Greens last night, we learned just how lucky it was. Rod, you like myself, you know, we grew up in it. They didn't have cell phones when we were in college and stuff like that. And Rod, he was good at a lot of things, but he didn't go check his mailbox very often. He just about missed a very important communication, or else who knows, your life would certainly not have been what it's been, Rod. But Rod and Jill are passionate alumni. They're passionate about Teal College. They're passionate about student success. I think passion is something that I think would be associated with the entire Wilt family. They've both served on boards at Teal College. Jill was the alumni director for a number of years, and Rod is a current member of the Teal College Board of Trustees. They understand the important role of being on a team and how that can play out in one's personal development. Now, is there any greater gift that any of us can give than to make possible the dreams of others? We asked a few members of the current wrestling team, Annette and I got to sit with some of them this evening, who were the 2015 PAC champions, to join us tonight and be a part of this announcement, because we wanted them to see firsthand how invested Rod and Jill Will are in your dreams, in making things possible for the wrestling program and for Teal College. Also, I think it's great that as part of this ceremony, we have in attendance current coaches, Craig Thurber, Craig Smith, and Matt Lowry, and former coaches, Mark Venus, somebody we're going to hear a little bit about later, Roy Wilt Jr., and once again, Dr. Robert Olson. You each played an important role in starting, growing, and strengthening the wrestling program, and I thank all of you for your dedication to our students. Now, the Wilt name, in addition to donating wood for the Hall of Fame, the Wilt name has an important part in our history here at Teal College. But tonight, we begin another chapter in that already extensive volume, one that celebrates the generosity of Rod and Jill. It is both an honor and privilege to announce that Rod and Jill Wilt have made the largest gift to a single sport in the history of Teal College and have permanently endowed the head wrestling coach position, a position that will first be held by current coach Craig Thurber and is now and will be permanently named the Rod E. Wilt, class of 1986, head coach for Teal College Wrestling. This will be the first endowed coaching position at Teal College and the first in the President's Athletic Conference. Thank you, Rod and Jill, and would you please come forward so we can make a presentation to you and also say a few words.
Wow, thank you, everybody. And I do have some very brief remarks because I do not want to take away from the class of 2015 inductees into the Hall of Fame. I congratulate each and every one of you and your families. It's a wonderful honor. It was a thrill for me when I was inducted, and it was actually a bigger thrill when my brother was inducted a few years later to be able to introduce him. But tonight I have some people with me that have loved and supported and encouraged me over the years that I'd really like to recognize. First and foremost, Troy, you did a wonderful job introducing Jill, a person that I met in Shakespeare class up here in Greenville Hall in 1985. It was a quick courtship. We met in May, were engaged in November, and married the following October, and that was 29 years ago this year. So it all starts with her. And she's just a huge, huge part of this gift, a wonderful family. And she lost both of her parents this past year, and this gift honors them. my son is here, my son Tanner, who is a big inspiration for me. He's been through his ups and downs, and he's pursuing his baseball dreams, and I know he's going to achieve everything he wants to out of his life, and I want everyone to say hello to Tanner. He's a wonderful, wonderful young man. And and then my family, my mom couldn't be here tonight. She's at a family wedding. But my dad, Roy Sr., and my brother, Roy Jr., and his son, Roy III, are here as well. So and then sitting with my dad and Roberta over there are Jim and Steve Biddle, who have been, well, Jim has been my dad's longest friend. I think I've been friends almost 70 years, and Steven, he's just, the Biddles are part of the Wilt family, and the Wilts are part of the Biddle family, and thank you both for coming tonight. It means a lot to me. Thank you, you guys. I have some really neat friends who I either met here at Teal or have met along the way that have come a long way, and to be here tonight, I just want to mention them very, very quickly. A guy was best man in my wedding, and Brad Lang is a class of 1981 graduate and a member of the wrestling team, a national qualifier here at Teal, and came all the way back from Chapel Hill, North Carolina. Don and Anahita Valesky, his wife Anahita, Donnie and I were teammates here and started this new chapter of Teal wrestling with Coach Venus, and just a wonderful, wonderful guy. Michelle and Guy, thank you for being here. Doug and Beth Stormer, all the way from Buffalo, New York, friends of ours. We met here on campus. Seated at our table over here, just great, great friends. Tim Loomis, he and his wife Sharon, very, very good friends of ours. Tim, thank you for coming tonight. I know you probably had to be here because you're on staff, but I'm thrilled you said yes when I asked you to sit at my table. Another teammate of mine, Dana Spires, all the way from Boston, Massachusetts, is here. And Dana, thank you. I know how busy you are, and two little girls and a family. And then friends of mine from Pittsburgh, one of the top NCAA wrestling officials in the country, John Nath and his wife Elaine are seated at our table over there. Johnny and Elaine, thank you for your friendship. Thank you for being here. Johnny wrestled at Pitt and is really, as I said, one of the top wrestling officials in the country. I got a really unique surprise when I came here tonight. I have three very special people in my life as well, my business partners. We started this company, Oakmont Real Estate Investments, about 4 years ago, and we've been fortunately very successful. And they're all younger than me, but they're all really, really neat people. And for a bunch of reasons, and neither of them could be here tonight. Scott Coy, Brian Uffelman, and Lisa Boyd. But when I came here, I was presented a letter from Scott, who's on a family vacation, and enclosed in a letter was a $25,000 check made out to Teal College Wrestling. So I just want to say thank you publicly to them. So we'll figure out how to what to do with that later. Craig, we'll have a little meeting and we'll figure that out. A couple people here at the college I want to thank, and then I just want to make a few very, very brief remarks. Dr. Van Aken and Annette, thank you for your friendship, but thank you for the leadership of this college as we head into our 150th year. Very special people, and I was thrilled to be on the selection search committee and then the selection committee when we hired Troy. And boy, what a difference he's made for those of you that did the campus tour and have looked not only on our physical improvements, but the improvements we made to this college under his leadership. Terry Hall and Roberta Leonard, thank you for your guidance in putting this gift together. And very, very special people. And Roberta's been a friend for a long time. And the president of our board of trustees right now is Dr. Barry Stamm. And my fellow trustees who have made a number of leadership gifts for this 2016 campaign. And without their leadership, I don't think I ever would have been moved to do something like this for the program. So where does the inspiration come from? Well, when you walk around campus on a beautiful day like today, it's not difficult to be inspired not only by the beauty of the campus, but for all of the history that we have here at the college. And for you cannot walk a step on this campus without stepping on a stepping stone or walking through a door that was made possible by the gift of somebody. And I began to think about that as we were talking about the 2016 150th anniversary of the college and the campaign that will be announced this fall. So that's really where the inspiration comes from. I grew up on this campus. Some of you guys, athletes in this room, babysat me when I was a kid, have been to our camp, made sure we had pizza or something to eat before we went to bed. And I remember the names like a Rolodex in my head. Very few of us involved in athletics ever get out of the sport what we want. We want to win one more match. We want to win one more game. We want to make one more shot. We always are done before we want to be done. But what makes athletics so significant is who we become by going through that process. We all share that bond in this family, whether you were an athlete or you're married to an athlete or a family of an athlete. That is imprinted on you. The success I've had and the careers that I've had are because I was an athlete and because of my Teal education. So what will make this gift significant? Well, tonight we're honoring a person who was significant in my life, Coach Mark Venus. And when I came here, I limped in on a cracked leg from John Carroll University, and he was first-year coach. And from the time I stepped in that room, he believed in me. What'll make this significant is when we have a coach here, like we now have in Craig Thurber, who believes in his kids. And I want to preserve that, not only for now, but for the future. So that when the next kid, and the next kid, and the next kid comes limping on in here from high school, or some other college with some unfulfilled dreams, that they have a leader here that's going to help them and guide them and teach them and motivate them and take them to places they never thought possible. That's what's happened to me when I was here, and that's where this whole thing comes from. So with that, again, congratulations to my fellow Hall of Famers. I look forward to hearing from you, and may God continue to bless Teal College Athletics and each one of you. Thank you.
This just gets harder and harder to follow these people. Thank you guys. For being inducted. The bar is set pretty high tonight, but I think you guys can cover it. What an exciting weekend has been, huh, folks? Well, it's about to get a whole lot more exciting because it's time to induct the newest members of the Teal Tomcat Hall of Fame. A 1966 graduate of New Providence High School, John Castaldo was the epitome of the Teal College student athlete. A four-year letter winner, John excelled in both on the field and in the chemistry labs. His scientific approach to football allowed him to diagnose plays from his defensive back position, which led to over 100 tackles in his career, including 52 during his sophomore year when the Tomcats won their first ever PAC championship. His nose for the football helped that championship defense intercept a school record 21 passes that year, a feat he helped match in his senior season when he was named All-Conference. Ever the athlete, John also punted for the Tomcats, averaging nearly 40 yards a kick as a junior. He also returned punts where he was prolific enough to still rank fourth all-time in punt returns and punt return yardage. He turned his chemistry degree into a highly successful sales career with a number of major league companies and is currently a sales rep for the Henson Sales Group in New Jersey. But he is most happy battling his new opponents on the other end of his fly fishing rod. I am truly honored to be the first to introduce to you from the class of 1970, Mr. John Castaldo, Teal College Hall of Fame.
Well, guys, what do I say but wow? We've had some pretty good orators before me. I got a very difficult task to try and keep your attention for a few more minutes, but I promise it'll only be a few more minutes. This is just probably the largest honor of my life. Other than my wife, I think, I know this is it. I mean, football has been such a huge part of my life. I never dreamed this would happen. I mean, I treasure every memory from Teal College. It's just a tremendous institution. It's a great place to come and get educated and to be transferred from a boy into a man. I'd like to thank a bunch of people because it wouldn't happen without them. First, my mom and dad for their selfless support in getting me here and keeping me here. And thank you, my dad, because he's the one who signed a permission slip because mom ran the family. She said, no football for you. So thanks, Pop. Just, Mom, don't smack him too hard. The Teal administration. First of all, they let me in. So thank you very, very much for letting me come here. Second of all, for letting me stay here. Because, I mean, football was number one priority. Sorry, Leap. Education was second until later on in my career here. But I'm telling you, it is the best thing that ever happened to me. It afforded me the opportunity to raise my family in the accordance with what I thought was standard for them. So I thank Teal College from the bottom of my heart. The athletic department, Leap, where are you standing? Boy, I'm telling you, people let me know, this man is resurrecting the athletic alumni. He really is by himself. Without him, I wouldn't be here. Dr. Vilenkin, you should be a coach because you've got one hell of a team. You too, let me tell you. I am super impressed. And I think Teal's future is in good hands, very good hands. I got to thank my former coaches, Jim McCullough, Mel Berry, John Dickerson, Bud Maines, who I really didn't see too much on the field, but without his scouting reports, it's our eye in the sky. We had the intel on everybody. We knew what to expect in every down, every distance, and we were tutored every week to know what to expect, where to be. When you saw it, you knew exactly how you had to react. That made my life a lot easier and a lot more productive. Coach Wayne Petracca, what can I say about Wayne? Without Wayne, I would not have completed my final year of football. I was ready to pack it in. He convinced me to stick it out, to play, and I did. I played hard. I played with all my heart. I miss Wayne. He was a very good friend. Excuse me. Then we have my gridiron gang. I mean, these are the guys that really made it easy for me to play. I didn't have to worry about anything but my own position. It made it very, very simple. We had outstanding athletes. We had a couple of All-Americans. John Gibson is not here, Gibby. I thank him for being my practice partner. He was the best receiver in the conference. Pretty much at the end in the nation as an All-American, and I took every liberty to practice across from Gibby. He let me hone my skills so I could be effective in the defensive secondary. John Tomlinson, what a great leader we had as a team. He was always there. You know, if we didn't toe the mark, come on, what are you guys doing? Get going. And he was always there by his example and leadership. A bunch of other guys that were there to really help me. As you guys probably don't know, my freshman year I played offense. So I got to play with Coop a little bit. He was our center. Guys I played with that really helped me, I got to mention, Paul Satternown on defense with me. He was right in front of me. He made sure that the The linebackers never got to me to block me or the guards coming around, so I was free to play the defense. Mike Donato, guys, you know what a plant is? I know you football guys. Does anybody know what a plant is? It's not when you, you know, dig a hole and put a flower in it. It's similar to it. You take the football player with the ball, the carrier, you plant him in that hole. Here's the leader. Here's the man who really knows how to do it, and he did it all the time for us, right in front of me. And I am the witness of that. A couple of special thanks to really close friends who aren't here tonight and played with me, Don Holman and Tommy Phillips. Tommy was our quarterback in the championship team. Phenomenal athlete, both of them. Another guy that helped me during that torrential senior year was, well, he played with a round ball, but he was still a good kid, Dave Thomas. He was really a big guy there to help for support, and a great friend. We got labeled, I mean, I was always with, John and I were kind of like, I don't know, almost Siamese twins. We were almost attached everywhere we went. So much so that our safety at the time, Jim Beard, another fantastic athlete, nicknamed us, and we became Kostocki and Ronaldo. We were there. We had each other's back. We were each other's shadow. And Jana was my roommate for 3 years until I got a better offer for a curvier model for my senior year. When I married my wife, Jean, who apologized for not being here, and this August 16th, it will be our 46 years as my roommate, so I would not have done anything without her. She kept me grounded when I thought I was the best thing in the world, and nothing could beat me. She was there to pick me up when I was feeling down, and most of all, she just made me a happy person all the time. So that's a special thanks that I have to give out to my wife, who's not here. So again, in closing, I thank the school for the honor. It is extremely important to me, and I will honor it all year long. I know, John, I went past 4 minutes. He didn't throw anything at me. I had a deal with John, and if I went past 4 minutes, he'd honk something at me. So anyway, Mike, after what you saw before me, breathing is difficult. So thank you all very much. I appreciate and accept this honor. Thank you.
This is such a cool event. It really is. I just love this thing every year. A sure-handed wide receiver, Jim Kick came to Teal as a 1978 graduate of Richland High School. Jim made his presence felt right from the beginning on his way to earning 4 varsity letters in his Tomcat career. The classic possession receiver, Jim was a typical Teal superstar, and he managed to get better each season as he capped his Hall of Fame career with a season for the ages as a senior. Listen to these stats: 56 passes caught, 1,147 yards receiving, and 9 touchdowns. Now remember, this is when it wasn't pass on every down. This is when you passed only when you had to. 75% of his catches came when it mattered most in conference games. He earned PAC Player of the Week honors for his 7-catch, 215-yard effort against W&J, which included 3 of those catches ending in the end zone. His stellar senior season still ranks in the top 5 historically for receptions, touchdowns, and yards, and earned him all conference honors. Jim also ranks 3rd all-time in career touchdowns and 5th in receiving yards. Like a lot of us, Jim is a Dave Miller disciple, graduating with a business administration degree, and his fascinating career has allowed him to be involved in projects ranging from FedEx Field, the home of the Washington Redskins, to the National Portrait Gallery, to Walter Reed Military Hospital, and Andrews Air Force Base. He currently serves as Vice President for Business Development for Century Contractors in Charleston, South Carolina. His wife Lori, daughter Rachel, son-in-law Grant are all proud Tomcat alums and are even prouder today, as it is my great pleasure to introduce to you Mr. Jim Kick, Teal College Hall of Fame.
So I get this phone call in February from Jack, and it usually goes like this. Hey Jim, I'm coming to Charleston. I need a golf event. Book around. And by the way, you owe me a check. So when he called and said I was inducted into the Hall of Fame, I was really honored. And, you know, I'm in great company. I'm going to do something a little different. I'd like Ron Lucian to come up, my wife Lori to come up, and Dr. Miller, I need you up here. Come on. Come on. Come on. Let's go. Come on. Well, you gotta shake it up a little bit, right?
I'm so tall, should I just stay down?
come on up here. You can stand here. Dr. Miller. He's the ambassador of Teal, right?
You are.
He's built a top-notch business program, better than anything that's in the country, right? But the best thing about it was he brought his real-life experiences to the classroom. And you know what? We could carry that forward through our business careers for our entire life. You know what? That's an invaluable asset for Teal. And I thank him for that. I got to play a little bit of football. I played for 4 years. I was in heaven. We started off with 44 freshmen, ended up with 11 really tight seniors. While we won some games and we lost some games, you know, that's life, and you just got to figure it out after that, and that's part of life. But I got to play with the likes of our Hall of Fame running back, Ron Lucien. Our Hall of Fame quarterbacks, Charlie Cole and Barry Holes. Got to play with Rich Parks, Denny Stevens, and Brian Hills. You know, it's just the greatest experience you could have in your life with the athletic part of Teal. And it's about the Teal Excellence Program. You know, it's all-encompassing. Now, 36 years ago in February, mark that date, right? We were doing a research project for our sociology class. It was in Kevin O'Donnell's room, and he was one of our running backs. There were about 8 of us in there, right? Anybody want to guess what the project was? It was trying to figure out the social impacts of drinking ice-cold beer while playing poker. Who wouldn't want to volunteer for that, right? So in walk these 3 hot babes, right? And one of them sits down, and we're playing poker, and she wants to play. So we deal her in, right? And after the first hand, she whispers in my ear, "Hey, you're dealing from the bottom of the deck." And I'm like, "Well, what's wrong with that? It's legal in a lot of states." So the second time around, I dealt her in, and she was happy. So.
Very happy.
So later that evening, we're talking, and she says, "You know what? I know just about everybody at Teal, and I know all the football team, and you're not one of them." And I'm like, "What?" So after several intense negotiations that included mud wrestling on the quad because it rained, we ended up settling, and she conceded that, "Yeah, I went to Teal, and I played a little bit of football." So fast forward to today, right? Next Friday, we celebrate our 33rd wedding anniversary. She's my biggest fan and my best advocate. And I want to tell her how much I appreciate that. But it all rolls into what's so great about Teal, right? It's about developing those long-lasting relationships that you have for life. And sometimes you even marry them. So in closing, I know Coach Reiser isn't here, but Jack, I'd like to give you a message to the football team, right? I would give anything, but my grandson Harrison, he's not available, to put that Teal Tomcat uniform on one more time and go out and play that game. Wouldn't that be fun? But at the end of the day, right, you don't realize the value and the experience that you have while you're here. It always comes later in life. So tell them to go out and have a great time, develop those relationships, get a great education at Teal, and play the game like you've never played it before. And to the Hall of Fame committee, thank you very much. Appreciate it.
A 3-sport all-star, Tracy Henderson-Orner, came to us from Ringgold High School, class of 1996. She embarked on her Teal athletic journey on the basketball court, where her quick hands and fiery spirit quickly endeared her to her teammates and coaches. By the time she ended her hardwood career, she'd amassed nearly 600 points, cleared away nearly 250 rebounds, picked opponents' pockets 125 times, and dished off to teammates 118 times. Her hustle and hard work turned into an all-PAC honorable mention selection and earned her 4 Teal letters. When they put the basketball away, she turned to the sport that would make her mark at Teal, softball. Tracy raised the bar immediately, being named the PAC Freshman of the Year in 1997 and was runner-up in that year's Player of the Year balloting. She would go on to earn 2 of those PAC Player of the Year awards, was named to 4 all-PAC teams. Her quick hands and understanding of the game served her well both at the plate and in the field. For her career, she averaged a base hit just about every other time at bat. Nearly a decade and a half after leaving Teal, her shadow still looms at large over the softball program as she remains the all-time leader in batting average, RBIs, triples, and total bases. She capped her Teal career by being named to the National Fast Pitch Coaches Association All-Region Second Team in 1999. And just to keep from being bored, Tracy earned a 4th place finish in the javelin at the 1998 PAC Track Championships. And the honors just keep coming, as this year Tracy was named to the PAC's 60th anniversary softball team. Earning a double major in business administration and business communication, Tracy brings the same hustle and dedication to her business career, where today she is an inventory management specialist for the New Pig Corporation. Forever a competitor, Tracy scratches the competitive itch by competing in bicycle racing events and is very active in local charitable causes. The Teal College Hall of Fame is better today with the addition of Tracy Henderson Orner, Hall of Famer.
First off, I want to thank you all for joining us tonight. It's an honor for me to have the opportunity to stand here in front of you tonight at the Hall of Fame banquet. I'm going to try not to get emotional, but it's kind of hard. This is something that you always dream about when you're a kid. With hard work and dedication and the right support, it does happen. First, I'd like to congratulate all the other inductees with all your accomplishments. You deserve it. It's well deserved. I would also like to thank Teal College for giving me the opportunity to continue my education and my athletic career, as well as the Hall of Fame committee for their decision to induct me in this year's class. I'd also like to thank my parents for all their support, guidance, and sacrifice to allow me to continue my education and my career. And to my coaches, teammates, and friends, thank you for pushing me to work hard, to be a better person on and off the field. Without you, I would not be here today. And finally, like I said, this is an incredible honor that I'll always cherish forever. Thank you.
Those pictures are incredible up there watching. It just takes you back. I mean, it's just such a great touch. Another Tomcat named to the PAC's 60th anniversary team, Randy Chicklin, graduated from Hamburg High School in 1999. As a foretaste of the success to come, Randy earned second team All-PAC honors as a freshman and a sophomore. He moved up to first team honors his junior and senior year and was named PAC Player of the Year in 2002. Possessing strong wrists and a very quick bat, Randy powered the Tomcats to the PAC championship his senior season. Terrorizing opposing pitchers for fun, Randy left Teal as the all-time career leader in 9 categories. Even today, he is second all-time in RBIs, third all-time in total bases, and remains the Tomcat home run leader with 31. Randy earned all-region second team honors in 2002. Demonstrating the same discipline off the field as he did on, Randy left Teal with a political science degree. Still driven by numbers, Randy shifted his focus to the world of accounting, where he has worked in both Atlanta and Pittsburgh. Today, he is a senior accountant for the UPMC Cancer Centers. It is with great pride and humility that I introduce to you Hall of Famer Randy Chicklin.
Pretty nervous being up here right now. I'm not used to anyone really listening to me when I talk to him with my 2 and 4-year-old son. So I'm going to try and get through this without too many stutters. It's such an honor to be included with the class. I mean, you listen to all the... So that's my Brett, and this is Ryan. They're a handful. Just listening to everyone and all the accomplishments they had, it's remarkable that I can be included with these guys and with all the other fellow Hall of Fame members. Thank you to the Hall of Fame committee, AD Liebheimer, president, all the coaches, especially Coach Shally, putting up with me for 4 years. I always tell them that it was a pretty lucky chance of me ending up here. I ended up going to Ashland my freshman year for the first semester and wasn't going to get some playing time there. So his brother, the head coach there, said, hey, there's this guy on my team. Maybe he could work at Teal. And Coach Shally called me up. I came in, and I guess history is written for this. I'd like to thank my mom and dad who were not able to be here. My mom passed away before my senior season, and without the support of my baseball family and friends, I don't know how I would have gotten through that. So, I'd like to thank my in-laws for being able to take their time to come here, my brother-in-law. I wanted to try something unique too. It's amazing. I was trying to think of what I was going to say for my speech, and everything just in my life pretty much comes back to Teal College for the most part. I met my wife here, Carolyn, which led to these guys. The education, which got me my job, and oddly enough, my boss actually went to Teal, so that helped, I'm sure. Most of the friends I still am in touch with, including Bill, who took his time to come here, are also from Teal. All my teammates, I try and stay in contact with them. It gave me the work ethic that I hope I can pass on to these guys. And don't play with the microphone. Okay. And it's amazing looking back, thinking about how I feel that it was the first year of Coach Shalley when I got here, and we were able to really turn a corner, I think, by the time that we won the PAC in 2003, that being a part of the team that turned the corner for baseball, because every year now we come back and I watch games and I follow them every year, and just like all the other sports, it's great how we keep building and building and building on. And with the people and the leadership that they have now, it's going to continue. You guys are doing great. This weekend was a great success, I think, just judging by the turnout here even. And I hope that it just continues, and would like to thank everyone again.
Coach Mark Venus came to Teal in 1982 following a successful high school coaching and teaching career. He spent the next 19 years building the Tomcat wrestling program into a perennial national power. He helped generate 15 NCAA All-Americans and 45 national qualifiers. But his academics first philosophy led 19 of his charges being named Scholar All-Americans. Coach Venus was honored 11 times as the PAC Coach of the Year and nominated 3 times for the Division III NCAA National Coach of the Year. His 72% winning percentage in dual matches netted his Tomcats 8 top 20 finishes. In addition to his dual match success, Coach Venus's teams finished first or second in an unbelievable 38 tournaments. Always willing to step in where needed, Mark also coached football, baseball, women's soccer, and women's volleyball, the ultimate team player. Making use of his multiple degrees from Fairmont State University and a master's degree from YSU, Coach Venus was a major player in the Teal academic world throughout his career. Advancing to the chair of the phys ed department in 2004, Mark served tirelessly on countless college committees and developed a popular coaching minor at Teal. Coach Venus topped off his coaching career in 2001 when he coached the school's first two three-time Scholar All-Americans, Sean Clark and Dustin Wilkinson. Today, Mark joins son Todd in the Teal College Hall of Fame, and it brings me so much pleasure to introduce to you Coach Mark Venus, Hall of Famer.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, folks, for so many coming today. I'm just overjoyed by the number of wrestlers and other sports people that are here to honor the inductees. And, excuse me, I'd like to offer my congratulations to my fellow inductees. You're very special. A couple of you I watch compete, which makes it even more enjoyable to see you come into this end of it. And I'd like to thank the college, administration, staff, faculty, and my fellow coaches while I was at Teal. Because without you, we probably would not have been able to achieve what we did. There's probably not a person on the Teal staff at some time I didn't get on the phone and ask for help or assistance. And that's the one wonderful thing. We kind of are all in this together. in one fashion or another. And everybody helps out each and every one of us. And goodness knows we were very fortunate that we had a lot of help. I coached a lot of things here. Soccer, volleyball, golf, baseball, football, and of course wrestling. Each one of them carried a uniqueness. The athletes I found were very special. They are here because they want to be. They're not here for a scholarship. They're here because they want to continue their competitiveness for a few more years before they move on in life. And that to me makes Division III very special. I interviewed with Coach John Dickinson. He was the current athletic director at the time. And it was on August 11th, 1982. And I had coached 11 years of high school ball. And by the grapevine, one of my friends was on the staff here and called me and said, they got a wrestling football job there. And would you be interested? Well, I was thinking about taking a plunge into college, and why not? So I came over and talked to John, and I prepared, found out about the college, etc. And I walked in, sat down, and I had met John before in recruiting on the recruiting trail. And John, we exchanged some pleasantries. John said, "Is it true that you're a charter boat captain?" And I said, "Yeah, I've been a charter boat captain on Lake Erie since 1979. And he said, "How big is your boat?" I said, "Well, it's 32 foot. It's ocean going." He said, "That's a big boat, isn't it?" I said, "Yeah, it's a big boat." He said, "Well, all things considered, you're hired." I said, "That was one hell of an easy interview, man." And it did come up in the conversation, I'll tell you that. And we still fish together. Last year, John, on my boat, caught on the same line a 12-inch perch and a 10-pound, 31-inch walleye. Pretty good day. And you also build lifelong friends in this business. And John proceeded to tell me a little bit about the wrestling program. And it wasn't a real good situation. It had been down about 10 to 15 years. Things were not going well. He said that the plan was we were going to keep the program going for two more years, and we're going to cancel it. So we had a death sentence. And I fired back and said, "Why are you keeping it around two more years?" He said, "Well, we have this one kid, he's sitting out there right now." And he said, "We're gonna keep that around because we think he's kind of special. And then we're gonna cancel." I said, "Well, listen, if we do some recruiting, we work at this thing, is there a chance of keeping it alive?" And I said, "Well, do me a favor, keep that quiet that you're thinking about giving us the death sentence." He said, "I will." We took my first day of practice, and I'd like to mention, I'm trying to stay away from mentioning names because, man, there's a long list of names I got to mention if I got into that. And I don't want to offend any of these fine young men I have out here. There were four guys at my first practice, four wrestlers: Ed Zadarko, Mike Harrison, Roy Wilt, and Don Valesky. Three of them are here tonight. And it was real easy to practice. One little section of mat, and me and four wrestlers. And I said, "Guys, we're going to try to make the best of this. Let's take it. And we're going to recruit. And we're going to do this. We're going to get it done." and we first started recruiting out in the student body. By the end of the year, we had nine of them, nine wrestlers. And we actually tied somebody. We went 0-11-1. We tied Worcester. And man, that was a big thing for us. And then we had nationals, and we got us an All-American. Don Valesky. He was our first All-American. But in the interim, what happened was something that has impacted my life and impacted every guy in our program. School started, I was coaching football, and I'm sitting around the office, and I'm doing both football and wrestling, and we're a couple weeks into the semester, and a gentleman walks in my office and sits down, and he said, "Let's talk a little bit about wrestling." I said, "Sure." And he said, "I'm disappointed in what I'm hearing." And I proceeded to tell him the inside scoop as to what was going on. We're talking 2 years. He said, "How do you feel about that, coach?" I said, "I want to keep it going. Let's do something special." And he said, "I'll be damned, that's what I wanted to hear." That guy was Bob Olson. And Bob has always been there for me. I said, "Bob, do you want to take part in this?" He said, "I sure do." So on the spot, I hired him as my first assistant coach. And he did pretty damn well. He parlayed that into the 18th president of this institution. There he is right back there. All kidding aside, we had a lot of fun. He was a tireless worker, and we really worked well together, and we became brothers, I'm going to tell you. We had some wonderful things. And he was my first assistant here, and the first year we went out and got 15 wrestlers recruited. Second year, we went 8-6. Boy, nobody expected that. Shock. Shock and awe. We used to talk about it. Third year, we went 13-1. And then we went on a run of about 10 years that we went anywhere, 15 wins, one loss, 18 wins, one loss. Couldn't beat John Carroll. Couldn't beat the John. Oh. I had trouble saying it for years. Finally, we did get him, but my good friend and colleague, a gentleman up there that is a great coach, retired, and we finally beat him after he was gone. I wanted to beat his butt so bad, though. Yeah. And that was kind of the start of things. I also had Roy Wilt was one of my assistants for a number of years, brought a lot to the program. He went on to help at Ohio University. He was one of my All-Americans. That's one of the things. Out of the four guys that were at that first practice, three of them were national qualifiers and two of them were All-Americans. John Reynolds was an assistant coach for me. We got John at 21 years old. Boy, talk about a horse coming out of the gates wanting to run. We had to rein him back a little bit. And then Bob Parker, when he retired out here at CP, he came on board, great technician, one of the finest coaches I know. Point being, when you turn a program around like we were enabled to do, I'm the first to tell you, I was the benefit of a lot of good people. Many people helped us do this. And that, to me, was the special part of this. And we started to gain national reputation, we were written up in several magazines about the turnaround that took place. How we went from canceling a program, basically, and having four people, and then doing what we did. I wish we could have done that in football. I tried. We were really close. I always felt we were three or four players away, Mo. And it could have happened real easy. It's tough. I have a hard time with that one. But I also want to thank my family. Because without them, I'm not standing up here. They had to give up a lot to do what we did. My wife, who I love so much, I was in third grade, she was in second. And she came up to me and said, "I really like you." And she's still sitting there over there after 50-some years. Tell you what kind of gal she is. I was head football coach, and I was assistant football coach for 12 years. Every Saturday, we played a home game, and we had to play it at Greenville High School. She would come over 2 hours before the game and clean the bathrooms. Okay? Because she didn't want the college embarrassed because they had a high school game the night before, and nobody was cleaning the bathrooms. And she would come over and do that. And that's not quite at all. She would then sell tickets for game ball to help the Blue Gold Club and our booster clubs. Then she would go upstairs in the press box, and my great friend back there, David Miller, who everybody's talked about, I could tell you a book of stories on him. Diane and him would run the clock for the game. And then when we started the Teal Invitational Wrestling Tournament, she would do the concession stand. And that was on our anniversary day. So every anniversary, instead of going out for a weekend or dinner or something, where are you going? To the Teal Invitational. Guys, you know how hard that is? Holy. So that was a rough go, but she never minded at all. With her at the table is a good friend of ours who helped on the Teal Invitational for many years. Then there's my son, who I love so much. I got a chance to coach him. And if you're any of you fathers that ever get an opportunity to do that, it's really an awesome. I got to coach him in football and wrestling. The good thing about it, he was really good. He's a Hall of Famer. And he had one up on me. And I never said it, but man, that bothered me. He doesn't now, not anymore, T. That next guy is Eddie Furlong, who's been a lifelong friend of ours, WrestleForce national qualifier. My daughter and son are Teal grads, and both of them, a great thing that I can say, have never been without a job. And as a parent, man, that is a good thing. And then my three loves of my life out of four are here, my grandchildren. And when you get a chance to experience that, there's nothing better. Grandchildren are the greatest thing. They come, you play, you have a great time, and then they go home. It's awesome. We have Cole. He's a wrestler, baseball player. We have Haley, who is soccer, dance, and basketball. And we got Delaney here, who's gymnastics and dance. So we stay busy as grandparents. And this is hard for me to take, but I have a granddaughter that's 13. She's not here, Brenna. Papa got trumped by the band and Waldemere. How can she do that? But that's where she's at. Is Ed Stevenson here? No, okay. In wrapping up here, I would like for all of my wrestlers to stand up, if you would, where you're at, for a minute. Come on, guys. We have 11 of my All-Americans here, and Coach Olson. And these are the guys that raised this program from the death. These guys lived it. These guys sat through 0-11-1 and took us to 47 national qualifiers, our dual meet record, 15 All-Americans, 20 scholar All-Americans, 8 top 20 finishes, 3 regional team championships, team record in terms of tournaments, 21 first places, 17 runner-ups, 6 top 8 finishes at nationals. Folks, what these guys did, that is big time in the wrestling world. That's big time. It was a tremendous amount of fun, tremendous amount of work. Paul, thank you. Blue Gold Club, they were wonderful to us. Once we got things rolling, Paul came to me as a Blue Gold Club president and said, what can you use? I said, well, we're wrestling on mats that are 162 years old. I said, man, that'd help. Next thing you know, got a beautiful mat. I never forget that. When there wasn't a whole lot of people knocking at our door giving us $10,000 wrestling mats, he was. So going into this Hall of Fame is just an offshoot of what these guys accomplished. I was along for the ride in some respects. I had a lot of good people around me, as you know, as you can tell. I don't think we could have done it without them. I also think this place was very special at that time. We were looking for from sports to win. We didn't have too many doing it. And I was real pleased that we were able to do what we did. So I'd like to thank the college for including me in the Hall of Fame. I'm just overwhelmed by it. And I know that Craig has continued the success and legacy, and he's got some of his guys here tonight. I watched the matches on the internet from down in Florida. And you know, you go from living a life in the fast lane to living a life in up here in Florida. And I wake up in the morning, look around and say, do we want to go to the pool or do we want to go to the beach? See what you got to look forward to? And Craig has done a great job with the program, and I hope that we contribute a small part of that to what they're doing now. Thank you so much.
At this time, we'd like to welcome back President Van Aken to make this all official.
John, Jim, Tracy, Randy, and Mark, please stand. Or don't sit down, Mark. Be it known on this day, the 30th day of May, 2015, we are gathered here on the campus of Teal College in Greenville, Pennsylvania, to enshrine John Castaldo, Jim Kick, Tracy Henderson Orner, Randy Chicklin, and Mark Venus into the Teal College Athletic Hall of Fame. This action publicly proclaims those principles and values inherent in and enriched by the Teal College experience as exemplified in the lives and careers of the aforesaid. They, by this induction, bring honor not only on themselves and their families, but to their alma mater as well. May their accomplishments here recognized serve as a lasting challenge for future generations to discover the best that lies within their hearts and their minds, and through disciplined pursuits, achieve excellence of the highest order. As the 19th president of Teal College, I hereby declare that they are now enshrined as members of the Teal College Athletics Hall of Fame.
As we wrap up the weekend, there's still some thank yous that need to be done. We want to thank AVI for all the food services that they handled all weekend long. There was a lot of activities. I want to thank Joe Andurka, the commissioner of the PAC. It's always great to see Joe, and thanks for wearing your Tomcat pin. We'll make sure we get some pictures of that to send around the conference. Thank you to President Van Aken and his incredible academic team. Thank you all the coaches who showed up. This is a big support, and we're really happy that you're here. Thank you to Jack Liepheimer for the opportunity to hang with the Hall of Famers, because God knows my talent would not get me in this room. It's basically my ability to tell a joke. Thank you to all the Hall of Fame Selection Committee for all your good work. I think you picked another five incredible people this year. Thank you to all you Hall of Famers who came back to make this weekend so special. Congratulations again to all the inductees and award winners. That would be me. And if you could hang around, I'm sure there'll be some pictures. And the wrestlers, they want a picture of all the wrestlers in one group out in the rotunda, if you could do that. And thank you all for coming. It's been a great weekend. It's been a great day. And we hope to see you back next year when we'll honor five more Tomcat greats. Thank you, and good night, everybody.